gosh, dang it! Why?
No, God, please, no!
Why didn't this player make the Pro Bowl? Well, didn't you vote for the Pro Bowl? No, but still, I'm entitled to be mad. Most keyboard warriors complain when a deserving player doesn't make the Pro Bowl, but they didn't help contribute when they elected not to vote. Instead, those that did vote focused their ballots towards the wrong players based off of their name value, rather than those who had career seasons. I'm Hassan Khan of Time to Football, and here are your top 10 Pro Bowl snubs of 2019. Number 10, Leighton Vander Esch. Vander Esch has recorded 140 tackles on the year, third most in the NFL. Bobby Wagner and Luke Kuechly were elected as the inside linebackers for the NFC, both who finished with less tackles than Vander Esch. Wagner and Kuechly made solid cases with their fumble recoveries and their sacks, but you can't help but to wonder that if Vander Esch had the same name value as Kuechly, would he have made it in instead? Number 9, Desmond King. Denzel Ward of the Browns was elected to the Pro Bowl after a great rookie season, but King's year is very similar to Ward's, only slightly better. Both ended up with 3 interceptions, but King had 9 more tackles and a defensive touchdown to boot. Pro Football Focus rated King as the second highest rated corner this season behind Stephon Gilmore. Number 8, Justin Tucker. Tucker is statistically the most accurate kicker in NFL history, and his 90% of field goals converted this year adds on to his legacy. Jason Myers of the Jets was the AFC's candidate, but he converted 33 field goals. Ke'imi Fairbairn led the NFL with 37, but he only converted 88%, while Tucker converted 35 and only missed 4. He also missed just 1 extra point this year, and well, it was the first extra point miss of his career, and we were just as surprised as he was. Number 7, DeForest Buckner. There's no question that Aaron Donald should have made the Pro Bowl, maybe even Fletcher Cox, who finished with 10.5 sacks, but what about Akeem Hicks? He had 7.5 sacks as compared to Buckner's 12. Maybe Hicks wants some love of the fans from his rushing touchdown this season, but obviously, Buckner has been a bright spot this year on a very bad team. Number 6, David Bakhtiari. Most know Bakhtiari because of his funny appearance on Conan, but he's been a great player as of late. Even Aaron Rodgers speaks highly of him. And to put that into perspective, when was the last time Rodgers spoke highly of anyone? Bakhtiari has been a second team All-Pro the last 2 years. This season, he's been the healthiest offensive lineman on a team with a lot of questions. Number 5, Christian McCaffrey and Alvin Kamara. Yes, technically it's 11 players if I put 2 in one spot, but the number 5 spot is more so to point out that NFC running backs balled out, and there just wasn't enough room to make the Pro Bowl. McCaffrey rushed for over 1,000 yards and recorded 100 receptions, while Kamara had 21 total touchdowns. They both would be higher on the list if Gurley, Elliott, or Barkley weren't deserving of the Pro Bowl nod, but each player respectively deserved to get in. Just not enough spots on the NFC roster. Maybe if we didn't have the NFC-AFC format and went back to the Team Rice, Team Sanders structure, CMC or Kamara would be in. Oh gosh, no. Let's please not go back to that format. Number 4, Chris Jones. Jones isn't a household name in the NFL just yet, and it's safe to say that factored into him missing the Pro Bowl. JJ Watt and Myles Garrett were deserving of the AFC defensive end spots, but Melvin Ingram is a little iffy. Ingram finished the year with 7 sacks. Jones had more than double the sacks with 15.5. Number 3, Matt Ryan. Considering that Ryan threw 4,900 yards, 35 touchdowns, and led the Falcons to a 7-9 record with an offensive coordinator that he never clicked with is pretty dang impressive. Drew Brees making the Pro Bowl was understandable, but what about Jared Goff or especially Aaron Rodgers? Rodgers making it is the perfect example of fans voting for him because of name value. Rodgers threw 10 less touchdowns and 500 less yards than Ryan. Now, Russell Wilson will replace Rodgers in the Pro Bowl, but what about Goff? Goff was good, but Ryan outshined Goff in every passing category. Goff is making it in over Ryan because of the Rams' success, and an all-star game should feature the best players that year, not the players on the best team. Number 2, Andrew Luck. Let's keep the trend of the popularity contest going. Luck was second in the NFL with 39 touchdowns. Patrick Mahomes was deserving of an AFC quarterback spot. Phillip Rivers was as well, with him statistically being the AFC's version of Jared Goff. But Tom Brady was the AFC's version of Aaron Rodgers. Brady had an average to above average year, but it was nothing like Luck's season, who threw 10 more touchdowns than Brady to the likes of Chester Rogers, Ryan Grant, and Mo Alie-Cox. Brady is a more notable name than Luck, and that's why he is in. And number one, Darius Leonard. This is just highway robbery. Leonard led the NFL with 163 tackles, which was 19 more tackles than the second-place tackle leader, Blake Martinez. He also did this in just 15 games. Think about that. He led the league in tackles as a rookie and missed a game this year. Leonard is officially listed as an outside linebacker, so you'd have to outvote Von Miller, Dee Ford, and Jadeveon Clowney. Miller and Ford had great years, but Clowney should not have gotten in over Leonard. Clowney had 9 sacks on the season, and while Leonard had 2 less sacks with 7, he had 116 more tackles than Clowney. Leonard is the perfect example of why you either need to start voting for the Pro Bowl or need to stop complaining. Agree or disagree with our list? Let us know in the comments below of other Pro Bowl snubs that should have made the list. Also, make sure to follow us on social media, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. The username for all three is @timetofootball, and subscribe to this channel for more top 10 lists just like this one.